Welcome to this video. Agroforests. Agroforests are key in the action plan for existence. Unfortunate disrespect and further or ongoing destruction. In all cases that the ancient Amazon Amerinds migrated, they did not have their fertile and productive ancestral grounds at their disposal that are fertile and productive because they enriched them and made them fertile and productive and this generation after generation. Most probably they lost important members and logistics and lost much of their knowledge and culture too. Similar to and probably in the same era the Harappan of the Indus Valley Culture, Bronze Age, seemingly suddenly lost their culture and knowledge when they migrated in a similar fashion, away from the Indus River in Pakistan, to higher grounds. Phases. The early Harappan phase, from 3300 to 2600 BCE. The mature Harappan phase, from 2600 to 1900 BCE, and the late Harappan phase, from 1900 to 1300 BCE. So for the Amazon Amerinds, these were significant and irreversible or permanent perturbations that were dominant in the past thousands of years ago, but ongoing until and after the year 1500. Ironically, it is the Amazon Amerind and the macaws that enriched us, genome, and the Amazon forest, their habitat, that we did not leave, not even part of, their main and most sacred, ancestral, places to live, or habitat, in peace. Their ancestral places, or ancestral homes, were largely built and or enriched by them from generation to generation. The agroforests and A.D.E. soils were like their potential and capital, that is so for the indigenous peoples, but also for the animals and the plants and trees of the forest itself. This is something that modern humans cannot readily understand, and exactly this not understanding by modern humans that eventually could lead to modern humans' demise. The context of the Amazon Amerinds seems to be not the same as our modern humans' context, but in my opinion we will have to integrate this Amazon Amerinds' context in our societies and economies if we do not want to be wiped out soon, possibly in the most unexpected and dramatic way. I already said this on other occasions, while this could seem a hedonic task, the solution will be hardly noticed, will need no extra effort, and cost nothing at all to anybody. Nobody will have to raise money for anything. We will only need to open, just a bit, our eyes, and see what we are not and what we are. It would be nice if we would see what is not sustainable and what is sustainable, but I think this, see what is sustainable and what isn't, is not even really necessary. Achieving sustainability would only give us extra satisfaction. Just as we do not see why the indigenous peoples still present this exceptional heart and brain health easily and naturally, we do not see how we easily would get it ourselves, too. This is the end of this video, thanks for watching. Please give a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Giving a thumbs up is also a way to know if you already assisted a certain video or not. I hope to see you in our next video.